Let me show you another example of these automated tools, and that is going to be used for creating ramps. So let me navigate to a view where I can actually see what I want to work on. So this is a recurring topic. What are the ways with which you can define a ramp which complies with the regulations?
I see. Mm-hmm.
That's something that you have to solve somehow, and we have a dedicated tool for creating ramps. Mm-hmm. It's connected to the stairs. It has a similar logic, but different settings.
Yeah.
So let me show you how that works. Just like with the stairs, you have to define a starting point and you have to define an end point, just like that. Obviously, you can type in the value if you want to go with the exact length, but now I'm just going to...
This can also be an L shape or something.
Oh, yes, it can be. It can be other shapes as well. Yeah, it can be cylindrical mm-hmm. or mm-hmm. arched way.
Yeah.
Now, what I usually do next, I define the width, and I just offset the points until I have the right shape.
Yeah.
And now comes the most important part, where you actually define the inclination.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I could go with the percentage if I know that, but now I want to make...
For example, if this is for an accessibility ramp or something like that, then you have to define a specific angle.
That's right, I can do that, but now I want to tie it to the... To this piece of slab or the entrance.
Yeah, so you already know from where it goes to.
To where, exactly. Mm-hmm. I know the values, the base elevations, and that's what I'm going to add now. So you have three choices here, or more than that, actually, it's four. But the point mm-hmm. is that I have to choose the option which allows me to define the base level and the top level. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you can have one of them fixed and then add the inclination, but I'm just going to go with that.
And just as in any other case in ARCHLine, these are measured from the bottom of the floor.
Oh, that's right.
There's a floor system in ARCHLine which you can change, and these are referring to those values.
That's right. I know that the top is going to be zero because that's the zero point of my project, and the bottom would be -300.
Mm-hmm.
And if I do that, the ramp is automatically created. One of the great things about the ramp tool is that you are able to assign a railing to it just like you would do with the staircase.
Yeah.
So you just have to go...
And again, it's important for accessibility ramps.
That's right. That's sort of a given. So you have to go with the properties and go to the railing, and it's going to be on the left-hand side. And the railing would be... I go with the steel profile. I know for a fact how this is going to look like. So here you go.
I see.
So that's how you create something like that. Obviously, now you can fine-tune this railing. Behaves separately from the ramp. It's not tied to it. It just gets the inclination information.
Yeah, it automatically adjusts itself, and then you can customize it. And one important thing that these railings that you have selected before for the ramp, those are the styles that you can save, that you can maintain in the software. The software is shipped with a default list of railing styles, just as with door styles and wall styles and everything else. You can extend those libraries, and you can use the existing ones or your own ramps.